So thank you so much for the introduction and calling me for this event. So today I'm going to talk about the directed resonant antenna, one of my research area, and it was the topic in my PhD also. And I will be talking about some of the fundamentals, analysis, and ideas actually what we performed in Dhanbad and IIT Kanpur during my PhD. I will be presenting. And currently we did a very good work in the direction of the circular polarization in dielectric resonators. So I will be discussing all those things. So in an introduction already all the things is told by the organizer. So these are the current PhD students and the graduated PhD students are listed here. And some of the part-time PhD students are also working with me from DRDO and some universities. The lab actually in Dhanbad is funded by the fund funder like DRDO, ISRO, SERB, TCUBE, and my host institutions as well. So apart from DRA, my research group is also involved in working in the metal antennas design, compact antennas, MIMO and cognitive radios. We are also working in active area antennas, and we are also engaging things researching metamaterial-based absorbers and AMC and other kind of structures. So this will be the presentation outlines. So I divided the presentation in three parts. One is a fundamentals. So in a fundamental, I will be talking about the DRA and its mode, its coupling, and the circular polarization, which is we are going to introduce in a DR. Then after, I'll tell you some of the analysis we performed actually. Some of the analytical methods, which is very old, but it is important to know us. And also, I'll show you some of the Eigen mode results as well to understand some of the basic ideas to start the simulation work over the DRA. And also some of the parametrical studies. I will be talking over the multi-layer multi-permittivity, then after hybrid DRA and the new coupling for the circular polarization in DRA. So let's begin with the fundamentals. So as you know, it is very important to know these things so that we can contribute significantly in this area. So let us begin with the dielectric. This is not a new thing. This is a very well-known, it started Richmayer, 1939, and the 1960 it was used in the microwave, developing the microwave filter oscillator design and all. In 2000, it is started in developing the antennas. It is going to be used as a radiator. So earlier, when it was not actually used in radiators, it was used in a filter and oscillator design. The reason was quite clear actually, because it shows very high quality factor, the low resistor loss in a range of 25 to 19 when we are using these DRs in the application of the microwave filters and oscillators. And definitely because we have a very high dielectric constant, so this is offering the smaller size. So there's no ohmic losses here. And apart from this is made of the ceramics, because the ceramics, we all know, like a very well-known ceramic actually is Al2O3, alumina. So the thing is, like the temperature stability is one of the very important parameter here, and it is not going to influence this up to certain temperature. Like microstrip antenna is all, the limit is 50 and 60 degree. After that, they are the results are going to be change actually because of the parameters and all of the materials. But here with the DR, they are very good. The temperature is stability actually. So in most of the extreme conditions where the too much cold or too much hot is there, so we can utilize the device made of. So let me talk about the modes in the directed resonators. So here you can see this is one of the fundamental mode and much more exploited actually in DR. to use in many applications like oscillator, filter, and all TE01 delta. There are so many reasons actually why we are using these things, because it offers a very good quality factor, first of all. And the fields and all, you can see here, the fields, we can visualize these things here. So the coupling mechanism and all the things are very simple to find it out. So like this is actually taken from a very important book written by the Kasfis. The title is Handbook of the Dielectric Resonators, Architect House, 1986. So this is the first book I would say actually where all the things explained properly for the DR. So you may use to start the DR with from this book actually. So here this is the formula actually by which we can find it out the resonance frequencies accurately with having some definitely some boundary condition that aspect ratio should be in between 0.5 to 2 and the permittivity between 30 to 50. Now the thing is, like DR is okay, like as I told you, this permittivity and the quality factor is very high actually, and it was used to develop particularly oscillator and filters. The reason is quite clear. If the quality factor is high, so S21 is quite good, means the insertion loss will be less, correct? Now the thing is, how we can make the radiator from the dielectric resonator? So the idea is actually here that if we use the low dielectric constant and moderate quality factor, okay, and the boundaries are open, fine. So there is a possibility that the wave may be detached from the surface of the DR. However, if we are using the very high dielectric constant, so the thing is, like if you try to calculate its reflection of the transmission at the surface, so it is close to 1. So it offers you the PMC, perfect magnetic conductor boundary condition. But like in practice, this is not possible, but we are very close actually. So that is why earlier the things are used, these things are used as a cavity. Now, when we are using the low dielectric constant, this reflectivity, this reflected coefficient and the transmitted, these things is not close to unity actually, and expect actually the radiation from the DR. Expect actually the radiation from the DR. And finally, the resonant frequency and all could be same similarly calculated like as we perform in a waveguide and all. And definitely we can utilize our different shapes, correct? It could be mounted over the ground plane. Now here you can see some of the advantages and disadvantages if you use the DR actually. So the size of the DR is depending on the resonant frequency and the dielectric constant of the material. So you can see here, this is a very basic thing, relation lambda naught over under root epsilon r. So if the permittivity is high, so the way the wavelength is going to compress within the body, it offers a very high radiation frequency. There is a no ohmic losses. That is why feeding mechanism, and we can excite different kind of modes. There is a one of very important thing is there, like from the mode itself, like if you know the mode, this is TE10 or TE HE11 delta, correct? So we can predict the radiation pattern. So this is one of the beauty actually of using the DR as a radiator. Now, along with this, there's advantage, definitely there are some disadvantage associated with these things. So what are these things? First of all, this is actually the made of the ceramic body, and you know, like since sensitization of the ceramics with the high quality factor and all, we can develop in a lab. But the thing is, when we are making or a cylinder or a rectangular piece of that things, so we require a very high density and all. So definitely it's quite a difficult process actually. And definitely when we are going with a different shape, correct, like from the conventional shape, like the cylindrical, rectangular, all the things are okay, but if you want to make it challenging actually. So this is one of the limitation I would say. Correct. Now here you can see a picture actually. So like this is from the HFSS. So like earlier it was in a metal cap or oscillator. Now you can make the boundary as an open an idea actually. Now this is somewhat that radiation pattern will provide you or there are some fundamental modes actually here like T01 delta, TM01 delta. So if you try to plot these things, so you will find that like this is the magnetic this it's look TM01 delta mode, which is the electric dipole. P stand for the electric dipole, and HE11 delta is again a magnetic dipole. It's like that, like we can compare actually TM01 delta mode with a monopole antenna. Correct. So the radiation pattern could be predicted easily. So this is one of the fact actually that with the mode actually one can predict the radiation pattern. So this is some of the fields actually. What are the fields existing? Like if you are talking about the TE01 delta mode, so definitely EZ will be zero and HZ will be some component, and it is that is why we are calling as a magnetic dipole. Likewise for TM01 delta, this is electric dipole, HE11 delta, the magnetic dipole, and likewise. So this is a very basic paper and given by these things, you know, from the Mongia paper, R.K. Mongia. He given actually some of the basic facts and some of the formulas by which we can calculate the field. So particularly, I use here the two shapes. One is the cylindrical DR, another rectangular DR. Correct. Now this is, if you see this picture actually, this is fed at the center. Correct. And this is at the peripheral. Now the thing is, let us try to understand what will happen actually. So when you, if you're feeding at the center of the cylindrical field around that, okay, and there will be electric field. So you can see this picture actually. So this is the magnetic field and this is the electric field. Fine. Now if you compare with the cast phase distance field profile, so we'll find that this is actually correct. Whereas if you are feeding, okay, coupling the D with this coaxial probe, okay, so the magnetic and electric and magnetic field will be like this, and this is similar to your HE11 delta mode. Correct. So the thing is, we here this correct where we can feed actually the structure so that desired mode we can get. So this is I'm talking about with reference with the conventional structures. Correct. If you are going to use some arbitrary structure, let's say like that, you need to start from the scratch. Okay. You need to do the model analysis, eigen mode analysis, and particularly how to fix the resonance frequency and all those things. So the boundary condition and all the things will be different actually. So you need to start from the scratch. That is why in my lab actually, basically the students are doing with the conventional shapes because it is easy to get these things first of all. A very limited number of companies are there actually. So the thing is, if you want to use the things, start the things, so you can use with the cylindrical DR or rectangular DR, this thing. Now coming over the microstrip technique actually. So here you can see this is what the microstrip line, okay, and over that we place the DR. Correct. So this is a direct coupling. This is a direct coupling, and this is the field profile. Okay, so field is going to couple like this. Now the thing is, if you place the same DR just beside to this microstrip line, so the fields will be different. So in this way, you can control actually the mode again with the microstrip. So here we simulated and we tried to verified actually the mode and all the things. So we used again the rectangular DR and these things, and we found that if we are feeding at the bottom of the DR, so we can excite the TE01 delta mode. Okay, so this is the field profile, and similarly for these things, For the rectangular DR, these are the field profile and this is the radiation patterns. Now, last, if you see last around 5 to 10 years actually, so if you see the paper, it's published paper, so you will find the conformal strips is one of the most used coupling method. The reason is actually quite clear actually, because we want to play with the surface current, correct? So it allows to complete electric current flow on the surface of the DR, correct? Means like when we are coupling with a probe and microstrip, correct? So we are particularly finding a location, correct? But sometimes it is like the thing is it is difficult to excite the higher order modes. And for the higher order modes like H11 delta or EH11 delta for cylindrical DR, it is quite difficult sometime, correct? So the thing is conformal coupling is will provide you the freedom actually, so that you can fix the mode easily, correct? The things are quite similar. If you so we experimented and we found that this conformal, this thing, the DR actually, and you can see this is the radiation patterns here, correct? These are the field profiles, and here you can see this is a T01 delta mode. Now one of the very important technique is the aperture coupling actually. So aperture coupling is somewhat, I mean, like if you are using the DR, so definitely you are getting the less bandwidth. The reason is quite clear, because the thing is between the slot the fields are tightly coupled, correct? But these advantages are there. What are the advantages? The advantages are that like when you are coupled with the DR, correct, so there is no excess field, you can, the parasitic fields are not there actually, and for that actually you can improve your cross polar, means the cross polar will be less, correct? And here you can verify the same. Now if you excite from the slots actually, so you can see the red part is very small as compared to the core part, so this is the benefit, but at the same time you are losing the bandwidth also, correct? And we satisfied this thing, the modes and all the things similarly, okay, as I have shown you the previously these things. And after that, in some of the application it is required that the ground plane and the feed line, everything should be on the same plane, correct? So these techniques are also used in a DR actually, and it is somewhat actually you can use, and you can find it out the good bandwidth and all, but there is a cross polar component here, because on the same plane you have the ground as well as the feeding mechanism as well, correct? So again we have experimented with the conventional shapes, and what we found, the modes and other things are quite satisfied, means we can excite the desired mode, correct? So here this is a summary of the feeding techniques, okay? So the thing is like if you are using these five basic techniques to couple the DR actually, so like particularly as I told you, for the aperture technique we are getting a very less cross polar component. Similarly the other things are like if you talk about the bandwidth, so in a coaxial probe it is the microstrip technique, and the confirm these things from the aperture technique. And CPW will also provide you the good bandwidth, but again there is a cross polar component. So this is the thing actually, you can take a screenshot as well of this slide. Now other part is actually the circular polarization. So the thing is like you can see the most of now tending towards the circular polarization, because now the thing is earlier if you see like in a mobile actually, so this is LTE what we are using, the 4G, correct? So you are using the two antennas, correct? One is a horizontally polarized and this is a vertical polarized, so that there is a less chances of the losing the signal actually. The same could be done with the circular polarization properties. If you have the circularly polarized antennas, so there is a less chances of losing the information, correct? So the thing is I believe you know this thing, circular polarization, how this thing, so I'm not going into basic all those things, but how we will do in a DR I will be telling you in a coming slides. Correct. Here, like polarization losses due to the misalignment and see phasing issues, we can reduce these things, and the weather condition and coverage actually. This is the photo taken from the CA Balanis actually, and you, this is just we want to show here that if this is the vector for the wave and this is for the antenna, if this is aligned, these things, so this is PLF, this thing is one, otherwise it having this, if this is a right angle, so this is going to be zero, so we are not going to receive any signal actually. Now if you talk about particularly the feeding techniques for the circular polarization, so in literature actually you will find it out, there are three things. One is a single field network, another is a dual and multiple field network, sequential field network. So how you will excite the CP actually? So we know there is a two orthogonal component and there is a phase difference of 90 degree. This is a basic thing, correct? Now this basic thing, how will you incorporate in a DR? Correct. This could be done two ways actually, correct? One is we can use if the orthogonal modes, degenerate modes, correct? So if we somehow manage the degenerate mode, like if I take the example of the cylindrical DR, correct? So the cylindrical DR, like HE mode and EH mode, if you try to find it out, these things, particularly EH mode, EH21 delta mode, so it will be going to provide you a degenerate mode. So this could be used for getting the circular polarization. But at the same time, the problem is that how you will find it out, the coupling or the feeding network, correct? The other part is that if you try to maintain the two different modes actually, and these modes are orthogonal, so the orthogonal properties could be satisfied within a DR and the circular polarization could be obtained. So like here, people done with the single field network, then after dual these things also, and the sequential field. So we need to find it out, okay, how to rotate the electric field or how to maintain the orthogonal fields component inside the DR. So there is a one example actually for you. So you can see here, this is, we use a rectangular kind of DR, and this is the mode of TE to X 11 delta. This is TE to Y 11 delta. Now if we somehow, correct, if we somehow add these two modes, correct, then what will happen actually, this is the orthogonal fields, TE to X, EX component will be zero and EY component will be there. Okay, the TY 11 delta mode, EX will be there. Now the thing is, if you are trying to add, so we will be getting the TE11 delta mode, which will provide you the CP property, correct, circular polarization. So we try to manage these things in some of the DR structures, correct. Now, so this is all about the basic things, what I told to you, correct. So I talked about the modes, the basic shapes, correct, how to couple, what are the feeding mechanism. Now the thing is, some of the part is the analysis, that how we will do these things. This is again some of the basic facts I'm going to tell you. So the thing is, like when we're talking about these things, calculation of the resonance frequency and all the things, so the first thing is coming in our mind, the Maxwell equations, correct. We cannot forget these equations. These are very important. Like we all are using the HFSS, so we are going away from these equations, correct. But these are really very, very important to know the things, so that you can predict before the simulations actually some of the things. Okay, so I'm not going into this. Already you solved these Maxwell equation many times, correct. So idea is to showing here there are some basic things, that how the people predicted the resonance frequencies and all. So these are the field components for the cylindrical DR. So we can find out different field components. Here you can see, correct. Now, this is one of the method actually I would like to discuss with you all. So particularly, this is magnetic wall method. So what is that actually? What is the use? The use is actually to find out the resonance frequency and the quality factor. Okay, and what they did actually, they use the cylindrical DR and they keep in a cavity. Okay, they suspended like this, means you can put a form here and you can you can assume this is suspended in the middle of the cavity. Now the thing is, they try to calculate the field in a different reasons. Like here, we separate out reason 1, reason 2, and there must be a reason 3 of in a DR actually. Now we know this is, these are the basic fields, basic fields, and this could be extended in a different reasons. Correct. So here, like here, this is, you can see these basic fields, like 1 stand for the reason 1 and similarly 2 stand for the reason 2. So they written all the field components, all this H field and E field components particularly, similarly for the reason 2 as well, correct? And then after, they apply the boundary condition, particularly at z is equal to 0, what will happen? So these are the boundary condition, and from the boundary condition they obtain a relation, and that relation could be utilized to find it out the resolution. So this is the basic thing, okay, basic idea, how to find it out, how to fix the resonance frequency actually. Similarly, after this method actually, somewhat correction also came, and the correction was called as a perturbation correction to the magnetic wall method. And what happens actually, they try to find it out the field in a different reason, because it is possible actually, if you are providing the reason number 1 and reason number 2, it is not actually acceptable, because the field profile, field in strength here and here and here will be different, correct? So what they did actually, they tried to find it out the field component everywhere, correct? And then after, they use the suitable boundary condition to fix the resonance frequency and the quality factor. So the cavity perturbation, I believe you might be knowing, to find it out the dielectric constant in a lab, actually in a microwave lab we are using this thing. So same kind of things we performed here, and this is the formula. You can see what they did, they calculated the energy in a different reasons actually, and then after they fixed this thing. So this is one of the accurate method, I would say, correct? Like the Mongia method you can use, correct? Mongia given the several formula you can use, but let's say if you want to design the new kind of DR, correct, new kind of shape, how will start, correct? You have to write it from the very basic. You have to start from Maxwell equation, you have to find it out certain expressions, then after you have to find it out the energies different, and after that you can find these things. So this is actually the method. Nowadays we have HFSS. We are going to put the any arbitrary shape, correct? And you run the simulation with the boundary condition, you are getting the thing. But for the knowing the physics actually, okay, you have to perform all sort of kind of things, correct? So okay, this is coming again, this slides, okay, so I'm going to skip this thing. Now that part is actually the analytical things, correct? And several paper, I just taken the 2 papers here, correct, because of the limited time. Several papers actually published in the last 20 to 30 years in the field of DR to predict these things, correct? And you can find it out how you can fix your resonance frequencies and all. Now coming over these things, over the HFSS, that how one can do the things. So we have taken a simple DR, correct, cylindrical DR, and these are the design parameter. We fixed height and radius as 10 mm 10 mm. The reason was quite clear actually. We want to fix H by A ratio is 1:1. Why? Because we don't want the degenerate mode. This is the philosophy actually. Now the Rayleigh constant we have taken around these things, and the ground plane of 100 by 120 mm, these things, two radius is this thing. And we run the simulation actually. So the thing is, you will find it out some frequencies actually, correct? And if you don't know these things, the formulas and all, correct, easily you will get. But the thing is, what is a good practice actually, if you have these parameters, you can use the formulas given by the Mongia, or you can also use the formulas given by the Caspase, correct? So what we experience that those formulas within the certain limits provides very accurate results, correct? And after that, we extended the idea for the multi-layer, multi-permittivity CD-Array. This is one of the idea actually to find it out the wide bandwidth, correct? Because of every layer having the different permittivity and the different thickness. So it will going to offer a different impedance, and hence by matching the proper impedance, you can claim actually the wide impedance. Here we have taken the HE11 delta. You can see here, this is a coaxial probe location, correct? And for that also, you can see some of the analytical method they utilized, correct? And they try to fix the resonance frequencies as well, correct? So AG was actually given analytical formulas for the multi-layer structure as well, but it is available for the two-layer system, correct? Now the thing is this eigenmode analysis, correct? The thing is like when we are going for the multi-layer structure like 3-layer, 4-layer, 5-layer, correct? It is really very difficult. So what we did actually, because we need to find it out its quality factor and the resonance frequency. This is one of the basic things. Now we just taken the 3-layer system, correct? And we used the eigenmode setup of HFSS, correct? And these layers actually having the directed constant of 6.15, 10.2 and 2.32. These numbers are actually, if you see, you can connect it with the Rogers materials, correct? So because we fabricated with the Rogers material, so we have taken the permittivity like that, so that we can fabricate easily as well. Okay, so the thing is, when we run the simulations and when we interchange these permittivities or these layers, these things, location of the layers, what we found that there is a small shift in the frequencies as well as the quality factor. Okay, but there is an important thing is that like these permittivities are very close actually. And when we check the mode actually, what we found that in all cases mode is actually HE11 delta. So this is going to be fixed. Okay, this is going, but if let's say the dielectric constant is very high and very low, so it is very difficult to maintain. Okay, so we are saying this is a looks like a HE11 delta mode. And one of the important outcome these things, I'll tell you in the coming slides actually, that what we got actually from the multi-layer systems. So you can utilize actually the eigenmode setup in HFSS to find it out frequencies as well as the quality factor of any arbitrary shapes of the DR or anything actually. If you use, I believe many of you use the eigenmode, the setup of the HFSS is really very interesting to know the frequencies and so from the initial case. I'm saying that if you want to start the research in this area, correct? So the basic thing is like that the students are taking the paper and they are altering the dimensions, and hence they are predicting, okay, this is a very close design, so that my resonance will be like that. So they are guessing actually. So not to guess actually, I'm saying not to guess. What you can do, you can use the eigenmode setup. You can if you want to propose a new structure, if you are thinking that it having the potential, if you can visualize perfectly the electric and magnetic field, you can use this setup and you can find it out this quality factor and this is the starting point for your simulations, correct? So do not go arbitrarily, I would say, correct? Everything systematically you can do in a DR, okay? This is just a verification actually, what I told you, that in a multi-layer these things, we just verified this is HE11 delta mode from the eigenmode setup. This is not a driven mode setup, this is an eigenmode setup, correct? So here you can see this is pretty similar actually, correct? This is a 3-layer system, this is a single layer, okay? From the cast phase book, okay? So the thing is, this is what I'm going to tell you, multi-layer, multi-permittivity system actually. It's very interesting because one can get the idea that how can improve the bandwidth, okay, systematically. So here, this is a very interesting figure if you see. So on a y-axis, one side we plotted the resonance frequency, other side is bandwidth. And on the x-axis, we plotted the aspect ratio, which is our d by h, correct? So what we found interestingly that around the aspect ratio 2, okay, the bandwidth is high, correct? And definitely the resonance frequencies keep going on, correct? Right? But the bandwidth is high. So here we are getting the guess actually, if we are using the d by h ratio close to 2. So one thing is that bandwidth will be okay, means acceptable range, as well as there will be no degenerate mode. Because earlier we started with the linearly polarized antenna. Okay, so this is the thing actually. So we run the simulation and we found that this is if you are using the permittivity 3 and this thing, so bandwidth is around 32%. So it offers a very high dielectric bandwidth actually if you are using the DR, these things. So we experimented actually, and we started with the homogeneous DR actually. Okay, and we used the permittivity 5 and 4.4 actually, and we found that these things, the resonance frequency is very close. The reason is here, this 4.4 is the FR4, so we want to fabricate. The idea is what we want to fabricate, because if you are, let's say, if you are using the permittivity 12, 13, 7, 8 like that, it is really difficult to get this kind of material. So the easy thing is that we can pull it out, means we can fabricate, so we will get the material, these things. And then after we move to the two-layer system, so here the observation was very interesting actually, that if you are keeping the topmost these things, epsilon R2 is a high dielectric constant, and the lower bottom one is a low dielectric constant, so you have been getting the good bandwidth. Okay, so we done different combinations, and we found the same these things, that if we are that the lower layer having the dielectric constant of 2 and the topmost is the 13.5, so the bandwidth is 48%. So these are some design rule actually, correct? You can keep the thing like in a Mogia paper, what he given presented in a the formulation, we just given the design guidelines, and between that, if you are using the permittivity, you will be getting the bandwidth in between that, correct? So this is the paper actually we published long back 2014 in MOTL, so you can find it out, these things. Then after we run for the three-layer system as well, and what we find out, the same theory actually. What the same theory? That if you see that bottom one is 2.32, middle one is 6.15, and top one is 10.2. So we are getting the highest bandwidth. Correct? We are getting the highest bandwidth. These are the design rules. If you are keeping the layer thickness in between these numbers and the permittivity in these numbers, so definitely you will be getting the bandwidth more, correct? Similarly, we run four-layer system, five-layer system, this thing, and we found that this theory is correct actually. If you are going from the lower to top, correct, with there is a restriction here. Let me tell you, there is a restriction here that we used here the HE11 delta mode, and we excited through the coaxial probe, correct? We excited through the coaxial probe, fine? And in all cases, okay, in all cases, radiation pattern is almost same. So this is the beauty actually of the DR, of the DRA actually, because the mode is quite unchanged, correct? Because the permittivities and all very close, it's very small deviation, so it is not going to change, alter the strength of the field inside the DR body. So we have almost the same kind of radiation pattern in all cases. Correct. So this is the final observation what we made actually, and what we found that we started from the homogeneous and to the four layer structure. So what we found that for four layer system is providing more than 50% bandwidth that time. Correct. And the quality radiation by this radiation quality factor radiation is around 1.32. It's very small. And then after we also again verified the mode and all the things. And we again compare with the cast phase, these things, and we found this is okay actually. So there is a theory actually. We found a theory, this thing, first time, that if we are arranging a layer in such a manner, correct, so you will be getting the bandwidth. So now the thing is, like, if you want to make on a product, this thing, this antenna, these things, with like, if you have the three, if you want to make a three-layer system, correct, So you know where you have to fix your layer, correct? And what should be the thickness. So in this way, actually, one can find out the white bandwidth. And this is the experimental this thing. So we use laminates, Rogers materials actually, and laser cutter machine and all the things. We done this. This is all the done actually. This is the things actually we done in IIT Kanpur. At IIT Kanpur actually, during my PhD work, these things. Okay, so this is the experimental results, and we found this. Okay, these things. These are the radiation patterns, and this is the gain. Now, coming over the ideas. So two things now we have. One is the fundamentals, correct? We have seen certain things, and analysis part I can summarize actually. In analysis, what we have seen, we can do with the analytical methods. We have find it out some of the analytical expressions, and we have a very good paper written by the R.K. Mungia, correct, by which you can predict the resonance frequencies and the quality factors within a certain limitations, right? Even you can use your HFSS or CST or any other software, correct, and use this model analysis setup to find it out the resonance and quality factor. So there are several ways actually, correct, there are several ways to find it out these things, right? Now we have now very good background. Now we can use all those things to make some good antennas, okay, or particularly wideband antennas or circularly polarized antennas. So these are the pictures actually I just arranged. Okay, so these are the circularly polarized antennas what we developed in a Dhanbad. Correct. So I'll tell you some of the ideas actually what we published. Okay, I'll try to show some of the things. It is not possible to show all the things, but some of the key points, correct, I'll definitely tell you. So the thing is, this is one of the shape. Actually, the idea came with the multi-layer theory, what we you have seen actually in the last slides, correct? So what we did actually, we arranged, if we arrange these multi-layers in a radial direction. However, it is quite surprising when you say how we can place actually the ceramics in a radial way. This is really a very tough job, correct? Very tough job to do these things. But because we use the Rogers material, so the thing is, the Rogers materials, if you see the property, these are the composite. Okay, these are the composite, means this polymer, ceramics and other things are mixed. So little bit flexibility is there actually. Okay, so we used to fabricate those things. So here the idea is that, okay, I'm going to tell you the idea that so that you can start actually. So like here, if you see, so in a radial direction, the permittivity is varies. So there you can see this is epsilon R1, epsilon R2, epsilon like that. But there is a change here. Change is here, like, because there is a probe here, correct? And you want to couple electric fields properly. So you can guess actually these things, like if you are placing the load electric constant here, so definitely there will be very loose coupling. And it is not going to further propagate. It may be going to propagate in some other direction. It may be going to reflect it. Right? Now, it means that if you are using the high permittivity here, so there is a chance that it is going to hold your electromagnetic energy and it is further flowing inside the structure. Correct? So here, what we found that if you are placing these layers, okay, in a ascending order, so we may be getting the wide bandwidth, fine. So what we did actually, we performed the simulations, okay, and the measurements also for the three layer systems, okay. So again, we used the different permittivities and all, and we used the different combinations here. And what we found, this is the bandwidth is around 82% in this case, correct. And even if you are going arbitrarily, okay, this thing permittivity and all means, like if you are free to choose any kind of permittivity, so you can go up to 104.78% bandwidth, correct? Okay, so you can see the comparison here. We compare with the homogeneous CDRA, we compare with the half split, we compare with the two layer and three layer system. And what we found that the three layer system is providing a very good bandwidth, more than 100%. Correct. So how to cut the materials actually? For that case, we use the water jet cutter. Okay. And here you can see the pictures of the fabricated one. Okay. So this is the single study actually, I would say. I'm claiming this is a single study where the in a radial direction, the permittivity is actually the fabricated one. Okay. So far. Now here we, after that we measured also and we found the results are satisfactory, but not good, I would say, because there's a problem with the three layer because the system is very complex. So you can see these things, 10 dB is going to touch these things. But the idea is quite clear that yes, if we are going to ascending order, okay, the theory, we maintain our theory here that we, if we are going ascending order in a radial direction, definitely we have a good bandwidth. Fine, these are the radiation pattern and all the things. I can skip these things. This is one of the structure actually. A ring we used. The motivation to use this ring is like if you compare with cylindrical DR, correct? So what you will find it out for T01 delta mode, as I told. So why this is non-radiating, try to understand. Okay, if you see the electric and magnetic fields, correct, and particular electric field, so there is a high concentration in a center, correct. Now if I say you, if you cut it out, this center part, correct, so definitely you are going to alter the boundary conditions. In this way you can alter your quality factor. So the same thing, just we experimented with partial ground plane, correct, and this kind of feeding techniques actually. So what we found that it is really this feeding technique as well as this DR combination is going to provide you a very good bandwidth, correct. And the coupling between is really somewhat very important, because if it is very tightly coupled, so you are not going to get anything, but it may be moderately coupled. Okay, so you need to run the simulation with things to maintain a proper gap. Okay, so these are the radiation pattern and all. And then after if you see the dumbbell shaped DRA, correct, this is somewhat very interesting actually. Now the thing is, I told you this thing that if you arrange the permittivity, like if you're using the coaxial probe technique, correct, and if you use the permittivity layer, that the layers actually, the bottom one is a lower one and the topmost is a higher permittivity, so you're getting a good bandwidth. It is quite clear actually. Now the thing is, the same idea is here actually, but there's a thing actually here. You can see the permittivity is same throughout the DR, and in the middle this DR actually just checked actually. So in the middle DR, okay, this is smaller, this thing, that is why we are calling it a dumbbell shape, correct. So here if you find it out, the effective permittivity is somewhat lesser actually, and this is what actually the reason of the wide bandwidth. Okay, not fully actually, but a reason of the wide bandwidth. Other reason is that, like if you see here this dumbbell shape, so it is going to couple with the periphery of this DR, whereas other DRs is coupled near to the center. So we are going to merge the two modes. One is a HE11 delta mode, another is a HE11 delta mode and TM01 delta mode, like that. So we are going to merge these things, correct. So these are the two reasons actually for this wide bandwidth. So this is the fabricated one, what we fabricated. This is the radiation pattern here. I'm not going with this, all the results actually, correct. Now, this is the work actually of circularly polarized DRA, correct. So whatever I have shown, this structure, this published work and all, this is actually I performed all this work in IIT Kanpur during my PhD time actually. So in Dhanbad actually, these things are my students, my group, mainly focusing over the circularly polarized DRA, and we contributed significantly in this area. And we found number of couplings, okay, number of methods, how we can excite the orthogonal fields so that the circularly polarized wave get excited, these things, and we have the circularly polarized antennas. Correct. So this is one of the structure actually, if you see here. So this is a summary, you can see here, this is the conformal strips are here. Correct. I'll show you what is at the bottom of these things. These are the conformal strips. Here the size is this, and the 10 dB bandwidth is 2.8 to 3.83, and the action ratio bandwidth is 2.75 to 3.5. This is around 24. This is good bandwidth actually. That's very good bandwidth. And the average gain, we given have average gain actually. This is 5.5 dB. So this is the structure. You can see the coupling. As I told you. So you can think of the two probes actually. Okay, placed on orthogonally, and it will going to provide you the orthogonal field components. Okay, so this is quite clear actually. If you observe from the coupling mechanism, so you can see, yes, definitely there will be also the field component, right? So these are the this is the steps actually what we followed to develop the antennas actually. So we start only one single strip, then after we just bend actually here. So there is two things actually. Let me tell you, there is two things, you know, when we are dealing with the circular polarized, one is the orthogonal component, another is the phase difference between this is should be 90 degrees. Correct. So we need to maintain these two things. So this definitely, these two vertical strip is going to provide the orthogonal component, and this is the strip is going to contribute in a 90. Like if you see, this is HE11 delta mode, first one. Okay, and this which correspond to figure B, again you have these things, but you can see here somewhat, correct, and in this way the back, sorry, okay, a microstrip, and here you can see a gradual change is there. The reason is quite clear actually, we don't want to lose the bandwidth actually, so there will be gradual change in the impedance should be required. So the thing is, we studied actually the placement and the orientation, and we studied the DR heights, correct, and because it is definitely we are going to get our dual mode, as well as these modes are going to be orthogonal. Okay, now the thing is, it is just a matching problem, because we need to play with the DR heights, correct, and the placement of the slots, correct. So we studied all those things. Okay, we started with the L slots, correct. Then after we place the second slot, and likewise for the matching and all, because as I told you, these two orthogonal components, we need to maintain the 90 degree phase shift. Okay, so that is actually done through the, and you can see here, okay, you can see here the different locations, okay, for the different location of DDR, we have the field component, and we found that these are the orthogonal what it was intended actually. So we got a very nice band in this way, and we performed all kind of analysis, as I told you in a these things in a previous design as well. If this is close to one, so this is a PMC, perfect magnetic conductor, but the thing is, if the permittivity is very high, what I told you, the permittivity is very high, okay, relative permittivity is very high, so this is close to one, otherwise this is very small. So the thing is, if you are moving tending towards to a 50 or 60 this thing permittivity, so you can expect little what this thing, this is a PMC is forming, correct. But here for the easy explanation, we opted this PMC concept, correct. So here you can see, this is the proposed antenna configuration. Okay, so here what you can see, okay, so this is we called as a phase number one, okay, this phase, this is phase number two, this is phase number three, and this is phase number four. And what we did actually, these all phases are 45 degree apart. You please check, this is all the 45 degree apart, means if I say phase number one and three, there's a angular this thing's angle is 90 degree, phase number two and four 90 degree, like that, fine. So now the thing is, the idea is that we somehow manage, correct, we somehow manage the orthogonal components, but the phase different we manage actually through this probe location and all, like what we did actually in the last we have seen in last structure actually, correct. So here you can see easily actually, so this is the antenna number one. We are just, we used a sector, and this will be the tangential field, electric field will be there, correct? And then after phase number two we introduced, and there will be 45 degree shift. Then after phase number three, okay, if you go continuously this thing, so definitely it is really good actually, and you have a very smooth response. So now what we did actually, we maintain the orthogonal component. This is the idea, that's all. This is the idea here, that we maintain the orthogonal component by the shape of the DR of this phases, different phases actually. And then after we analyze in the same way, and because the orthogonal components are there, probe is at the perfect location, definitely we are going to get this thing. We analyzed we performed another analysis as well, and what we found that E theta in E5, and we plotted these things, and we found this thing that phase difference is 90 degree actually here. And we also checked by plotting the electric and magnetic field as well. And this is the antenna design guidelines. Okay, this paper actually, this work actually, we just published this thing published in 2018. And this is the design guidelines we have given, but not actually in a paper actually. This was we given for the question answers. Correct. So one can do the designs actually at the different frequencies as well. And finally, we measured and we found the things are okay, right? So this is all about these things. And these are the references we used actually, correct? And I would like to acknowledge my students who contributed significantly in this area. One is Mr. Rajkishore Kumar. Now he's completed his PhD. And Mr. Rakesh Chaudhary, he is currently working with me. So thank you all, and if you have any questions.